Welcome to San Juan, Puerto Rico. Now behind me is the incredible Coliseo de Puerto Rico, Jose Miguel Agrelot, the host venue of the 70th Miss World Final, or at least it should have been. On the day of the final, the event was sadly postponed due to an outbreak of COVID, but not before the spectacular opening sequences were recorded. This is the 70th Miss World Final.
Argentina. Puerto Rico! Delfinia. Republic of China. Curacao.
Pégate un poco más, pegado a los tambores, olvida los temores, el tiempo se nos va a mover. Pégate un poco más y mueve esas caderas, mamita cosa buena que a mí me pone mal. Ay, no.
Ireland.
Morena, bailame ese ritmo con sabor a pena. Deja ahí una pececita, pasa de llorera, para que te olvides de todas tus penas. Y esta noche quiero más,
Guinea.
Esta noche quiero fiesta, yeah, yeah. Hoy no habrá mal que por bien no venga.
Philippines.
Unamos los corazones, hoy todos somos multicolores.
Costa Rica. Bosnia and Herzegovina. Madagascar. Malta. Nigeria.
Que venga, bien pegadito, que venga, con mucho cariñito, que venga.
Tunisia.
Que vengan ríos de bondad a todos los pueblos de la tierra.
Chile.
Que no podemos olvidar que el amor puro libera y la mentira envenena. Que como decía mi madre,
Honduras.
Bailando todo se arregla. Pégate un poco más, venga a los tambores, olvida los temores.
Turkey. Albania. Haiti.
El amor que venga para nuestros niños,
que venga
la paz,
que
venga todo,
Senegal,
que venga bien pegadito,
que venga
con mucho cariñito,
que venga
Somalia.
Olvidar que el amor puro libera y la mentira envenena. Que como
decía mi madre, bailando todo se arregla.
La luna está celosa porque tú brillas más que hermosa. De ti me hablaron las estrellas. Esos ojitos me tienen descontrolado. El mirarte no he parado. Regálame una noche entera.
Y yo te doy lo que quieras.
Que yo te doy lo que tú quieras.
Yo te doy lo que quieras.
A cambio de un tour por tus caderas. Qué rico fuera. Ay, qué rico fuera.
Mongolia. United States.
Yo voy a ser que te dé doble, que estoy más jugosa con Goshi.
Bahamas.
Me come completa hasta los pies. Que no sea una noche, quiero un mes. Mete ni chascona, I'm a mess.
Equatorial Guinea.
From you I can learn a lot, teach me your ways. Solo son las dos, ya vamos para un tres. Dime papi, ¿cuándo que te vuelvo a ver?
Rwanda.
Una noche entera.
Que
yo te doy lo que quieras. Que yo te doy lo que tú quieras. Yo te doy lo que quieras.
Angola.
No perdamos más tiempo, es posible que esta noche terminemos en el mismo lugar a solas.
Vietnam.
Tu ropa, dos copas, tu boca, mi boca, una cosa llevo a la otra. Hay muchas que me tiran, pero para serte sincero no quiero a otra.
Gibraltar.
Sudando la gota, ese licor te tiene en la nota. Eso allá atrás como te rebota, Uri grande está que explota.
Brasil.
Una noche entera.
Bolivia.
Por tus caderas, qué rico fuera, ay, qué rico fuera.
Perú.
Dame una noche entera, que yo te doy lo que quieras, que yo te doy lo que tú quieras, yo te doy lo que quieras.
Luxembourg.
Por tus caderas, qué rico fuera, ay, qué rico fuera.
Spain.
Portugal.
South Africa.
Ay, qué rico. Ay, qué rico fue. Ay, qué rico.
Namibia.
Una noche entera. Que yo te doy lo que quieras. Que yo te doy lo que tú quieras. Yo te doy lo que quieras.
Dominican Republic.
Quedo con esos ratitos en lo que me dio una sonrisa. Hay días arriba, días nunca más se acuesta.
Guadalupe.
Hey. La vida. La vida tiene
Japan.
Yo sé que el mundo se te vira al revés, pero yo me quedo con los momentitos en que te besé y te besé. Te pones muro,
Trinidad and Tobago.
Te pones meta donde a lo mejor no llegaré, pero yo me quedo porque desperté, desperté y desperté, porque la vida es un regalo.
Bueno.
Yo es un regalo que se aprovecha, por eso hay que vivirlo y vivirlo como una gran
Korea.
Puerto Rico, we are live. Please welcome your hosts for the 70th Miss World, Peter Andre and Fernando Allende.
Thank you. Buenas noches, mi gente. Happy to be here with you. Welcome, viewers from around the globe, to the 70th Miss World Final. We are now live from the beautiful city of San Juan, Puerto Rico. Special thanks to the mayor and people of the city for making us so welcome and lending us your beautiful, enchanted island as the backdrop for this magnificent 70th anniversary celebration for Miss World.
I mean, that's some opening. 70 members of the Puerto Rico Philharmonic Orchestra, led by Angel Velez. How amazing is that? Now, since it's the 70th anniversary of Miss World, let's use our imagination. Mm-hmm. 1951. Do you remember that?
Yes, I do.
And the Lyceum Theatre in London opens its doors for the very first ever Miss World final. The dress code, white tie. The gowns, formal. And the orchestra plays the music of the night. Tonight, we will be taking you back to the big band era, just as it would have been 70 years ago, in our search for the new Miss World. 98, thank you. 98 contestants came to the Coliseo de Puerto Rico, José Miguel Agrelot, is that right?
You got it, now, finally, yeah, thank José you. Miguel Agrelot.
Porque te quiero es así tu dulce beso.
Well, okay.
And the judges chose the top 40 to advance to tonight's live event. We'll meet them after the break.
We'll be right back.
Our contestants enjoyed 4 weeks of competition to find a place in the top 40. The first of these events was the head-to-head challenge. Let's see how they got on.
Mentioned in the video, my passion is for education.
We have, as people, so much more in common than what sets us apart.
Because life is that. You have to be prepared for everything in life.
Today we have with us our head-to-head challenge finalists.
This is still just the beginning towards uplifting an entire community.
Education is such an important determinant of who they will be in the future.
What a competition. 1.4 billion views and 70 million votes. The head-to-head challenge has certainly captured the imagination of the entire world. The other unique feature of Miss World is the fast-track qualification from 5 key events, with the winners of each qualifying for the semi-final.
Again, for our annual sports event, held this year at the Mayagüez Stadium. Ireland set the record for the 100 meters. She was followed by Iceland's dashing sprint, setting the bar high for the day. Then it was the shuttle run, where Sweden finished the last sprint and took her team to victory, winning the shuttle run by a massive 10 seconds. A time penalty shootout against the undefeated Puerto Rico Soul WFC.
I think that what's really helping me is my great cheerleaders, the green team, and also just staying focused and believing in myself.
An early start to the day saw 6 groups of contestants battle it out for the fastest length of the pool. The overall winners are first place, Mexico, second place, Iceland. Third place is tied by Guinea-Bissau and Ireland.
The Multimedia Challenge is a fast-track event based on social media interactions with the fan base. Contestants win by gaining the most traction.
Social media is very important because it allows people to connect, feel a sense of belonging, and feel valued.
It definitely has been super fun to share my platform with the other girls. We've been making videos, making pictures, we've been posting stories, and people really like that.
With millions of votes cast across multiple platforms, it's been a very close competition. But there can only be one fast track winner. And that winner is Côte d'Ivoire.
We'll be right back. Time to have a look now at the incredible performance that gave Mongolia the Miss World Talent 20.
Whoa. Is she going to need a chiropractor after that one?
Maybe.
I have a really good one. I'll give you the number later. Well, thank you, Ms. Mongolia. Let's keep things moving again with our next Fast Track Top Model. Here we go.
There's nothing quite like a Miss World Fast Track Top Model Final. An international event showcasing stunning designs from the world's most talented designers, modeled to perfection by our contestants. The show kicked off with all contestants taking the catwalk, modeling dresses by some of Puerto Rico's most talented designers. Change into their chosen designs from around the globe, all competing for the World Designer Award.
Said I see ya, I see ya. Ain't nobody that can beat ya. Said I see ya, I see ya. Yeah, we do it like. We do it like, yeah, yeah, yeah.
top models are shortlisted by the judges, who chose their top three for the Top Model Award.
For the life that you dreamed as a kid.
Despite their show-stopping performances, there can only be one winner. And once again, our judges have their work cut out. And the 2021 World Designer Award goes to...
Korea! It's an honor to be wearing one of his dresses by Andre Kim and his son, Chung Do Kim. I'm so excited and thrilled. It still feels like a dream.
The top model results are in.
In third place, Puerto Rico! In second place, Cameroon! The winner, who has secured her spot in the semifinals of the Miss World 2021 final, is...
Côte d'Ivoire!
I'm so honored. I'm so happy. I feel like I just brought my country to another step for this competition, and I'm thankful to God. I hope all my people from Côte d'Ivoire are watching, and this one's for you.
What a way to showcase the very, very best Puerto Rican fashion designers across the world. A big thank you to all of you for making this such a memorable night. Thank you so very much. Time to head back to the Coliseo de Puerto Rico, José Miguel Agrelot, and to enjoy a choreographed performance by all of the Miss World contestants wearing the stunning design of the official dress designer of the 70th Miss World Final, Ashley Lowell Brennan.
Miami me lo confirmó. Puerto Rico me lo regaló.
Come on.
Those silver dresses were absolutely stunning. Thank you again to Ashley Lauren. Now, that was the last time we saw all of our 98 contestants together before the contest was sadly postponed. Moving forward to tonight, it's time to meet the top 40 in Miss World.
Hello, I'm Carolina Vidales representing Mexico. I am an activist, model, and bachelor graduate in international business.
I am Olivia Yase from Cote d'Ivoire, and I am a graduate with a bachelor's degree in marketing and management.
Hello, I am Palesa Molefe from Botswana. I am an actor, producer, and writer.
Bonjour à vous. I am Audrey Nadilamonkam, representing Cameroon, a BSc degree holder in banking and finance, and a model.
I am Namrata Shrestha from Nepal. I am a student of sociology and a certified kindergarten teacher.
I'm Shanice Palacios and I have a bachelor degree in communications and I'm from Nicaragua. El invierno llegó.
I am Betania Borba from Paraguay. I am model.
Mabuhay! I'm Tracy Maureen Perez, industrial engineer, model, and a host from the Philippines.
I come from Venezuela. I am a medical student and model.
Welcome back. Now, we've seen who qualified from the preliminaries, so now let's meet the remainder of our top 40, starting with the six Beauty with a Purpose winners.
Hi, I'm Rahema, representing England, and I'm a health technology consultant.
Hola, I am Vanessa Varanasi from India, and I'm a computer science engineer.
Hi, I'm Sharon Nobara from Kenya, and I am a psychologist, a special education professional, marketer, and a baker.
Hola, I am Shudufa Zomusila from South Africa. I'm an author, student, and the owner of a non-profit organization.
I'm Sri Sani, and I'm from the United States. I'm a business manager and social entrepreneur.
Hola a todos, I'm Amira Hidalgo, I'm from Argentina, and I'm a journalist.
Hola,
Evans from the Bahamas and the owner of Access Medical Labs.
Hello, I'm Caroline Gomes Teixeira. I represent Brazil. I am a law graduate, sportswoman, and model.
Hello, my name is Svetlana Mamaeva. I am proudly representing Canada, and I work as a business technology analyst.
I'm Carol Derpich from Chile and physiotherapy student.
I'm Jiang Ziqi, a model and an entrepreneur from China.
Everyone, I am Andrea Aguilera and I'm from Colombia. I am a social communicator and a professional model.
Hello, I'm Carolina Copinsola and I represent the Czech Republic. I'm founder of Step Into Life Foundation.
Hello, hola, I'm Amy Peña from the Dominican Republic. I have a bachelor's in journalism with a minor in marketing, and I'm also a full-time model.
Hi, I'm Amar Pacheco from Ecuador, and I'm a singer and an actress.
Hello everyone, my name is April Benayoun, I'm a model and I'm from France.
I am Niniva from Guinea and I am an accountant.
I'm Yelita Upati. I'm from Hungary and I'm a student.
I'm Hurum Birta Egilsdóttir and I am from Iceland. I am a spokesperson and a volunteer for a charity that helps the less fortunate.
I'm Carla Jules from Indonesia. I'm a host, model, and a chef.
Hi, I'm Pamela Uba, and I'm representing Ireland. I'm a medical scientist and a part-time model.
I'm Lillian Zaratin, proudly representing Madagascar. I work in the insurance and mutual field.
Hola, I'm Lavanya Sivaji from Malaysia and I am a medical doctor.
Hi everyone, I am Anna Leach and I am representing Northern Ireland.
I'm a primary school teacher from Cookstown.
Hi, my name is Karina Bielawska and I represent Poland. I am doing my master's in business studies.
Hola, I'm Ariane Diaz Rosado from Puerto Rico. I'm a TV presenter and a model.
Hi, Bovan. My name is Shadi Greenwood and I am representing Sri Lanka. I am studying international relations in Japan.
I am Khadija Omar, a psychology student, a makeup artist, and I am from Somalia.
I am Janine Brandt, representing the Rainbow Nation of Trinidad and Tobago. I am a makeup artist and beauty consultant. This is the greatest show, party in the island. If you're feeling the vibe, raise your hand.
I'm Đỗ Thị Hà from Vietnam. I'm junior student and model.
I am Burto Jing Ano from Mongolia and I am contortionist.
Congratulations, ladies. You are the top 40 contestants in the 70th Miss World Finals. And one of you will be the next Miss World. It's time to take a break, and when we come back, we will go on tour with the contestants as they enjoy the beautiful island of Puerto Rico, la capital del paraíso, Puerto Rico!
In the gorgeous Caribbean island of Puerto Rico. For our contestants, it's the trip of a lifetime as we are welcomed to a beautiful island paradise.
What a wonderful welcome to Puerto Rico, from delicious pineapple drinks to music and wonderful people. We're so excited to be here.
Whatever floats your boat, this island has it all. From great beaches, culture and sport, to history and spectacular scenery. Once a Spanish colony, Puerto Rico is now home to over 3 million people. It's a vibrant, colorful destination, and we can't wait to start exploring. From our lovely base at the spectacular Hyatt Regency Grand Hotel on Cocoa Beach, we set out to explore this beautiful and welcoming island. But where to start? How about a delicious local drink?
Really sweet. I just got brain freeze and tingles in my nose.
And a boat trip to Matalagata, a mangrove island off the south coast of Puerto Rico. We're given a great welcome with delicious food and the choice of just kicking back or getting a little bit more active.
We just had the most wonderful time here in Matalagata. The food, the ambience, the music, everything was exceptional.
Trip to San Juan is also a top priority. It is home to some of the greatest museums that really capture the history of the island.
We are visiting the Museo de las Americas, and how you can see, it's very big, it's very colorful.
Actually interesting, because a lot of their culture is similar to my culture, because in the Cayman Islands, we're only a few hours away from here, and I'm learning that we're more similar than we are different.
Hi world, we've come to San Juan and the tourist board here have kindly gifted us a passport of Puerto Rico so we can mark all the places that we get to visit. And obviously Miss World is in San Juan this year, and we got a little Miss World sticker right on San Juan.
We took some time to visit a historic site from less happy times.
I promise I will never be late again, I promise.
This former prison is now, thankfully, disused.
This used to be the prisons. In that cage, there were more than 10 people in there. Other people that used to be here for a long, long time in short, little space.
Ponce is Puerto Rico's second city on the south coast of the island. Overlooking the city is the historic Cruceta de Vigia, which stands as a monument to the watchmen who were tasked with protecting the town from pirates and invaders. Ponce is a beautiful place and also has some stunning Catalan-inspired architecture, like the Castillo Serrales.
Coming from an island myself, I understand just how important tourism is as an industry in a country, and that is why I am so happy to showcase the beauty of Puerto Rico.
Ponce is also rich in cultural assets, which means that there's plenty to see and do.
This is a station bomba, and I love the way they've conserved it. And this truck that you guys actually see here is a fire truck that is more than 100 years old.
This has been a great day for strolling around, but now the tempo is about to get a bit faster.
1, 2, 3, 5, 5, 6, 7.
So it was so fantastic to have a salsa lesson here in Ponce, in the open space. It gave us so much energy and power to go on for this tour. So excited.
And if you want to keep up the speed, Toro Verde has some of the longest zip lines in the world.
And we are in to ride the second longest zip line in the entire world.
I'm not ready for it.
A little nervous, but that's good. That's good. Yes, we conquered the monster.
I can't believe I did that.
We did it.
By total contrast, we also visited El Junque, the only natural rainforest in the United States.
It's my first time to visit like such a place. It's so wonderful. I've never seen something like this before.
We have these magnificent trees, beautiful waterfalls. It is absolutely stunning.
A nearby river cruise is a great way to see the area.
It's really beautiful. We don't have this in France, so it's discovering new things in nature. It's pretty cool.
Other highlights included a trip home for the Puerto Rican contestant to Miss World, to Naranjito, where she did her Beauty with a Purpose project.
I feel so happy with a lot of emotions because this is my home and I will never imagine all the world is going to be here today.
We were made very welcome and enjoyed music from young performers she had worked with. We also attended the opening of an art gallery in Old San Juan. Everything on display is presented digitally.
We are at the Lighthouse NFT Smart Gallery in Old San Juan, Puerto Rico. This is the grand opening. As you can see, people are still finishing the polishing touches. Just a matter of weeks, we have renovated. We've kept the historical elements, but we have brought the digital world into the physical. And we have some incredible artists that are coming, Logan Paul, Marcel Van Louis.
And then there's the nightlife. Puerto Rico is an island that knows how to party. Our contestants had the best time of their lives on a night out in Rio Grande. Puerto Rico is somewhere very special to visit. The local tourist industry has worked hard to make this a welcoming and exciting destination with loads to see and do.
This is the first time for me in Puerto Rico.
So I was very excited to witness the seas right in front of my eyes.
I wasn't expecting anything because I've never been anywhere, so everything is nice and
I'm definitely coming back to Puerto Rico.
And there's more to this world after this break. Performing at It Better Be Tonight, please welcome the Puerto Rico Philharmonic Orchestra, directed by Angel Velez. So there are your top 40 in the 70th Miss World. After the break, we'll reveal the top 12. Don't go away. Sadly, ladies, this is the last time we will have the opportunity to see all of you together. Because now it's time to announce our top 12. And I'm going to start with the first semi-finalist for the top 12 is our digital media winner. This is a new competition in the conjunction with our digital media partners. Roundtable created individual websites for each of the contestants, and the winner who best used their website to engage with their fans worldwide. The winner is the digital channel's winner is Vietnam.
How you feel it?
Wow, I'm feeling above a fantastic. I can't believe that I can stand here in top 12. And at this time, I feel a lot of pride and honor to represent my country, Vietnam, in Miss World. And being called Vietnam by others is the best feeling ever to me. And I'm grateful, extremely grateful to represent my country. And I want to send a lot of thank you to my brother, my country. Thank you so much.
Oh, congratulations. Wonderful. Back to you, Fernando.
Here we go. Will, this is the second semi-finalist. And I'm very proud to announce that the second one is Mexico.
Congratulations, you're in the top 12. So what life experience most defines you?
Well, Peter, I think that a very important stage in my life was definitely my childhood. Coming from a family of migrants, very humble farm workers, I really, right from a young age, I learned the true value of hard work and really being perseverant. And to this day, I believe that when you work hard and you stick to your dreams and you really see beyond any limit, any circumstances that may be difficult in that moment, anything is possible. And being here today is proof of that, so I'm really happy. Thank you.
Well, congratulations to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mexico. And here we go. The third semi-finalist belongs to Northern Ireland.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Peter. Thank you, everyone.
So what have you learned as a teacher over the last 18 months?
Well, I would say I have learned that I am so much more motivated at the idea of children's success and their development and how much of a vital cog in the engine I am as a teacher of young five-year-olds, especially over the past 2 years due to the pandemic. And the pandemic, it's really uprooted a lot of education systems across the world in every country. And it has had a huge impact. It's put an incredible amount of stress on senior management, both senior management and a lot of teachers. And I feel as an ambassador for Aware NI, which is a mental health charity in Northern Ireland, it's my job to lobby for care and change to be implemented in lots of education systems across the world because I really hope that Miss World, I mean, I know it would be a fantastic catalyst to help implement that campaign.
Fantastic. I have a five-year-old too, and he drove me crazy through the pandemic. Thank you very much, Northern Ireland.
Thank you so much. Here we go for the fourth semifinalist, and it goes to the Philippines.
Mabuhay. Now, you've got a lot of love here tonight, which is fantastic. How can you use your journey to inspire others?
Thank you, Peter. Well, if I told any of you my life story, my experiences, you would also probably wonder, how in the world did she get here? Well, you know what? I'm so much bigger. I'm so much stronger than all of the unfortunate things that had happened to me. And I know in my heart that all those experiences led me to this very day, to this very stage. And I want people to see me, to see themselves in me, and be reminded that what we go through in life should never dictate where we'll ever be. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Congratulations, Philippines.
And Fernando. Here we go. This is the fifth semifinalist. And this goes to Poland. Yes.
Hello. Witamy. Is that right? Okay. What's your greatest achievement and why? Sorry, let me ask that again. What's your greatest achievement and why?
Well, I believe that all of us today are dreaming about having a successful life. What I've learned is that it's more valuable to have a significant life. There are a lot of titles I'm proud of. I got my college degree, I became Miss World Poland. I'm here on this beautiful stage tonight, which I'm super grateful for. However, there was one title I never dreamed of, which is a title of being a volunteer, the one that actually makes your life fuller, full of purpose, full of gratitude, full of humility. And maybe none of us can be famous, financially successful, or have a worldwide careers, but all of us can be great because everyone can serve. And this actually makes life more beautiful.
Well said. Thank you very much.
And we present to Puerto Rico and the world the sixth semifinalist, and that goes to Somalia.
Yay! Well, you look amazing. Salam alaikum. What inspired you on your journey to the Miss World stage?
Wow, this is so shocking. What inspired me to be here today is I've had a dream to always be a representation for so many young women, to also shine light on the issue that's happening in my country, the climate crisis that have been displaced. And I just want the world to come together, love our difference, because there's so much issues that we need to focus on. And if we come together and we stand together, we can fix so many things in this world. Thank you.
Beautifully said. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. Okay, that is our sixth semi-finalist. We'll be back with our next six after this. Welcome back to Miss World. Now, my dear friend Fernando, and what a lovely voice you have, sir, please continue with our seventh finalist.
Wonderful. I'm going to give you the name and the country that she represents. We are on the seventh semi-finalist. Good luck to all of you. You're all winners, anyway. Here we go. Number seven semi-finalist, and that goes to USA.
Congratulations. Now, the whole world is watching, so what message would you like to give to everybody watching?
Well, as someone who has seen many struggles in her life, from undergoing heart surgery for a pacemaker implant just at the age of 12, and also surviving facial burns, my message tonight is about resilience. And especially to anyone who may be watching at home or listening and going through a tough challenge, I want you to know that you can rise up from any challenge in your life as long as you have a possibility and a solution-oriented mindset. Remember, as long as you have a heartbeat, you have a purpose.
Very, very inspiring, and I love your confidence. Thank you very much, Fernando.
The eighth semi-finalist, representing Colombia,
wow, Colombia, how are you?
Oh, I feel amazing. This is just a fantastic night.
It's really good when you feel amazing and you look amazing, as you all do. Okay, so what would you like others to learn from you?
I would like that people learn that the real happiness is always inside. So don't try to find it outside because it's not there. I would like people learn from my own life's experience that dreams do come true. And this is the proof. I'm here in Miss World 2021 representing my whole country, Colombia. So please don't give up. Work hard with discipline, passion, love, and you can accomplish everything you want.
Yes, lovely. Thank you very much, Colombia. I feel very inspired tonight.
Yes, indeed. And here we go. Allow me to introduce to you the ninth semi-finalist. And this goes to the Czech Republic.
Ahoy, Miss Czech Republic. Congratulations. What motivated you to create your own foundation? Not again.
Ahoy. Thank you for your question. You know, every single smile of these children motivates me and gives me an energy. And Miss Ron motivates me too. It is a chance for me to make my voice stronger. I'm ready to be here for everyone who needs me. I'm ready to work. I want to continue building my foundation, not only in Czech Republic, but also in the world, because we have 157 million children who lives in orphanages. And this is what motivates me. This is when my heart is.
Well said, well said. Thank you so much.
10 semi-finalists. And this goes to Vive l'amour, France.
Bonsoir, Miss France. Congratulations. What is the most important value in your life?
Bonsoir. Bonsoir à la France. I would probably say benevolence, because this value includes so many others, such as kindness, altruism, patience, and we are all different. This is what makes us special and unique. And we all want to be a better person every day. So don't forget to help, don't forget to love, and don't forget to do everything with your heart.
Fantastic. I 100% agree. We need a lot of love in the world at the moment, right?
11 semi-finalists, and this goes to India.
Namaste. Okay, if you could break any rule, what would it be? Congratulations, of course.
Thank you, Peter. A big hello to you and a big hola to Puerto Rico for so warmly welcoming me to this beautiful island, not once but twice. If I could break any rule, it would have to be the unwritten rule about success. I think that society has this definition about success. It ties it to power, money, wealth, and fame. But I don't fully agree with this. I think that success is about this bigger purpose that you connect yourself with. It's about the positive change that you drive through your thoughts and your actions. I think that's what really matters. And influence is only meaningful when you use it in a way that is good. And I think this is a rule that I would not only want to break for myself, but for everybody here. And I think it would make the world a much happier, healthier place.
Yeah, fantastic. Thank you very much. You can stay there if you like. Thank you, Fernando.
Semi-finalist number 12. It goes to Indonesia.
Apa kabar?
Baik, terima kasih.
All right, what lessons have you learned from being a chef? She's a chef, you know.
There are actually numerous life lessons that I have learned as a chef. I'm going to pinpoint it to 2 points. The first one, do not be afraid to make mistakes. Mistakes are bound to happen, especially when you are, it's your first time starting it. And besides, mistakes are the best teacher of life, yes. And the second, last but not least, I'm pretty sure everyone here agrees that the secret ingredient of everything is love. It's love. And when you pour some love into it, and you watch it transform into something beautiful, something magical, and if I could say, it's something delicious. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now, someone's whispering in my ear telling me that we have a tie. Is that right? Not a bow tie. Fernando, you can reveal it.
A 13th semi-finalist, and that one goes to Cote d'Ivoire.
Congratulations. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir, Peter.
Okay, your hashtag is assume your identity. So what do you mean exactly by that?
Well, you know, Peter, a lot of people suffer from mental health and from self-rejection and don't assume themselves. So assuming your identity is about accepting who you are, whether you're black or white, whether you're tall or short. It's about acknowledging that whoever you are enough. So when you see that hashtag, know that it's about representation. And it's about what the world benefits from you because you show up as you are and you shine. And I'm convinced that there's no better fulfillment than being proud of what you represent. So wherever you are back there, back home, to all of you here tonight, remember to always assume your identity.
I'm really happy with that because she said it doesn't matter if you're short. So that makes me feel very good. Congratulations to our top 13, and please show your appreciation for the remainder of our top 40 who put so much effort and time into returning to Puerto Rico, who've helped make tonight's event such a huge success. Thank you, ladies. Now, when we come back, it's the heart and soul of Miss World, beauty with a purpose.
with a Purpose is the central theme of Miss World. More than $1.4 billion, billion with a B, have been raised for good causes throughout the world. And here in Puerto Rico, the fundraising was the main focus for the Miss World Charity Dinner aquí en Puerto Rico.
So today we're at one of the most important events of Miss World at the Fairmont Hotel, our Beauty with a Purpose Gala.
We heard that tonight is a special night. It's also about, it's about fundraising.
We started Integra Foundation to be able to help Puerto Rico. Very basically, we want to be able to help Puerto Rico thrive.
The very best of luck for the talent competition.
Done a wonderful job. Congratulations. Big round of applause.
Are you enjoying Puerto Rico? Are you having a good time?
I'm enjoying every single minute in Puerto Rico.
Tonight we will reveal the five Beauty with a Purpose winners.
So tonight, I'd love you to see some of those projects.
It has been such an honor and a privilege to be able to turn my pain into a purpose.
You're all invited to be part of the groundbreaking ceremony. Thank you.
Miss Kenya.
Thank you, Miss World, for inspiring me since I was young to serve. And I hope we all continue to serve and donate.
So I have very good news for you. Every single dollar raised tonight here will stay in Puerto Rico.
$15,000. There's got to be a little more light in this room. $15,000. $25,000. $25,000 going once. $60,000 going twice. $60,000, ship it to the corner.
Every contestant creates a humanitarian project to support the disadvantaged in their own country. The judges have already selected the six top projects. Let us meet the Beauty with a Purpose finalists. And one of these girls will be our Beauty with a Purpose winner. So, we will tell you the first ever Beauty with a Purpose ambassador after the break.
I at Regency Grand Reserve is the premier resort in Rio Grande, and was the home for the Miss World contestants. Here they are enjoying the sun, the sea, the sand, and the sound of Island Girl.
Girl, you make me burn with desire when you move like an island girl. Oh baby, show me the fire. I love it when you dance like an island girl.
Ay, como tú no lo hace nadie. Yo te pongo a bailar.
de tus amigas, no con nadie. Pero tú conmigo no pares de gozar. Oh, oh, when you dance like an island girl. Oh, oh, when you move like an island girl. Like an island girl.
Okay, great song, great song. Okay, the winner of the Beauty with a Purpose ambassador will accompany the reigning Miss World to a Beauty with a Purpose project around the globe. Each finalist will now make the final presentations before the judges choose their winner. Beginning with England.
Education is the most powerful tool for our generation. And I believe that by educating our youth to recognize abusive behaviors and understand healthy relationships, that lives and generations can be changed. It is through my own experience of domestic abuse, stalking, and harassment that I felt compelled to stand up, speak out, and fight for women experiencing such injustice. I use my own experience to start conversations with other women about their experiences of domestic abuse in the hopes that a safe space can be created for women to share their stories and lessons they have learned. I choose to stand up, speak out, and fight for women experiencing all forms of abuse.
There are thousands and thousands of children who are pushed into child marriage or child labor. One call stood between these children and a future of darkness. 10-9-8. This is the Child Care Helpline and my project to help the government of my state, Telangana, in their efforts to prevent any kind of distress to children. The first step was creating awareness of the 10-9-8 hotline. As a spokesperson for the campaign, I use public events, social media, news, and TV to create awareness. All across the state, these specially designed vehicles help rush children to safety and create more awareness of the mission. There is so much work to be done, like extending this program across all of India, strengthening our support services with vocational training and exercises and counseling, and I can see many sleepless nights are ahead. Project 10-9-8.
Despite having a Mental Health Act in Kenya and a developing healthcare system that seeks to deliberately focus on mental wellness, a lot of individuals are still suffering in silence.
The story of Leah Cheruto in a remote village in Nandi County in Kenya, who was chained and locked away for over a year before the intervention of well-wishers.
One of the ways that we can end stigmatization is opening the conversation on mental health.
you know, using our social media platforms like the way Sharon Obara is doing to end the stigmatization against mental health.
Since being crowned, I have rallied support amongst Kenyans and brought in partners in government and the private sector to help normalize conversations around mental wellness.
The government, through the Chief Administrative Secretary in the Ministry of Public Service, Youth and Gender, Honorable Rachel Shebesh, who also happens to suffer from bipolar disorder, have strongly come in to support my advocacy journey in destigmatizing mental health and wellness in Kenya.
With the help of Maureen, through her platform, we are training the solo mothers, equipping them through IT, equipping them through their personal and financial training. We can then provide them a livelihood for them and their family.
In every smile and laughter, every narrative told in words or silently spoken in tears, I see a reflection of my mom. Her tenacity to face obstacles and her grit to overcome them all. That is my driving force to fight for this cause. I know that by taking care of them, I'm also taking care of her. From organizing health and wellness activities to trainings for livelihood, our unified efforts are making waves to uplift the lives of the mothers and that of their children.
The most meaningful part of winning the crown was the voice that Being Miss South Africa gave me, a voice that allowed me to be an advocate for people suffering from mental illnesses. We began our Instagram live sessions in February 2021, and within months, we had over 1 million viewers. Women are particularly susceptible to feelings of being unworthy and feeling less than. I was mercilessly bullied as a child, which made my school life unbearable. Since my mission was to dispel the myths around and remove the stigma from mental illness, I wrote about my own experience in a children's book, Shudu Finds Her Magic. To date, we have donated 2,500 copies of the book. I'm so very proud to say that it is currently the number one selling children's book in South Africa. This journey has reminded me of a quote by the father of our nation, Nelson Mandela. Education is the most powerful weapon you can use to change the world.
For me, the biggest accolade will forever be the sincere conversations I've had with people who shared how my vulnerability and messages helped them heal.
I weekly wrote emails and made phone calls to inspire people to donate. I was able to raise $24,000 for Variety's children's charity.
In 2021, I passionately worked alongside 41 nonprofits, and the US government honored my service with Sri Sandy Day. There are still more hearts to be healed, and I want to inspire everyone I meet to not have limiting beliefs, to intentionally create joy, and be of service to others.
Together with Miss World, we can bring more joy and healing to broken hearts. If you have a heartbeat, what's your purpose?
Beauty with a Purpose winner is United States. Okay, congratulations. Right, let's announce the remainder of our judges' choices. Okay, we have second finalist is Poland. Our third finalist is Indonesia. Our fourth finalist is Mexico. A lot of love for Mexico. Our fifth finalist is Northern Ireland. And our sixth and last finalist is Cote d'Ivoire.
There's more Miss World after this break.
Welcome back to Miss World.
Thank you. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce Puerto Rico's first Miss World, and she is Lady Wilnelia Forsyth.
We bring the world together tonight to offer our love and support to all the people who are suffering as a result of the events in Ukraine, including Miss World Ukraine 2016, Alexandra, who is currently in Kiev. She sent us this message.
Today, I woke up at 5 to the sound of bomb explosion nearby. I pray to stop this war. I pray that children won't die under fire anymore, that women won't hide in bomb shelters, that men won't suffer on the fronts. I pray that we Ukrainians will live peaceful life on our native land.
Our thoughts and prayers are with Miss World Ukraine and all whose life has been so devastated since this conflict began.
And watch us where we go, and help us to be wise in times when we don't know.
started with Kiki Hackinson in 1951. And you know, all of you ladies share one thing in common. You have already won the crown and taken your place in history. Let's see a little bit of that history now as we celebrate the 70th year of Miss World.
Tonight, we are making history as we celebrate our 70th anniversary. Over the years, Miss World has changed beyond all recognition, redefining the concept of what this kind of show should be. But let's step back in time to the early 50s. These early shows are a great success with TV viewers. From the start, Miss World works hard to raise money for children's charities in partnership with the Variety Club.
I don't think people realize that Miss World is more than glamour. Maybe that's how it started, but since the very beginning, it has such strong charity element in everything they were doing.
By the 60s, Eric Morley, Miss World's founder, has become a household name. And he even has his own catchphrase.
As is customary, we shall announce the results in reverse order.
By the 1970s, the show has moved into color, and is about to make the major change that will refocus the entire competition.
It was a total game changer. It established the true purpose of the organization, which was always to make a difference.
Under Julie Morley's inspired guidance, the show reinvents its charity work as beauty with a purpose, challenging the contestants to really get involved and undertake important projects that benefit their own communities. From now on, the only vital statistics that really matter are those concerned with saving lives and improving outcomes for millions. By the 80s and 90s, Miss World is not only a global brand, but a massive force for good, raising millions and drawing attention to some really difficult issues. In 2000, we bade a sad farewell to the founder, Eric Morley, but Julia takes up to the challenge of running the business and pushes Miss World into the 21st century.
Today's competition is more about the modern woman. We have teachers, we have doctors, we have architects. We can all display our talents. We can say that we're good at sports, or we're good at singing, or we're good at whatever. That's why Miss World continues to thrive.
Tonight, the simple, brilliant idea that Eric Morley created and Julia reimagined, refocused, and reinvented is now a massive force for good.
CEO of Miss World launched Beauty with a Purpose 50 years ago. We, as Miss Worlds, have lived that purpose, empowering young people to shine the light in the world. Julia, we love you for everything you have given to this world, and to empower us, you gave us. And you always tell us, it doesn't matter what you did yesterday, it's never enough. To honor you in this very special occasion, returning with a song that echoes what you tell every Miss World. Ladies and gentlemen, future the Puerto Rico Philharmonic Orchestra, Tony Ann with Never Enough.
Share this with me, 'cause darling.
Question will decide the next Miss World after this break.
Okay, the all-important final question, the last hurdle between six astonishing women and the ultimate accolade. The contestants have randomly drawn a number during the break, which corresponds to the person who will ask their question. Your question is from...
What have we learned from the COVID pandemic?
Good evening, all. I have learned from the COVID pandemic that we can always try harder to be better and to improve in life. During the COVID pandemic, I think we all went through a lot. But the most important was to try to push through and to always try to find a solution, because I believe that in life, it's not about falling, but it's about every time you fall to be able to get back up.
Okay. Excellent.
Next question, guys.
Question number two. Can we ever overcome inequality?
Yes, absolutely. I do think we can overcome inequality by respecting each other between women and men. And I do think that equality will submerge if we keep each other and we keep respecting each other, our presence and the way we think. And that is why I think that we can overcome if we are joined together and we can overcome it. Thank you.
Third question.
Which human right do you value the most?
The human right that I value the most is dignity, because when we listen to other person's perspective, we're able to communicate with them, find their problems, and give them solutions. So it's very important that we see everyone as equal, even if they live in places or are in situations where they aren't blessed with the basic rights of shelter, food, water, healthcare. We need to give the gift of dignity and listen and provide solutions. And that is exactly the work that a Miss World does. She helps communities around the world by giving resources and aid. And it would be my highest honor to be your ambassador for Miss World.
Another question, please.
Certainly, the next question is, Nelson Mandela said that Miss World was the most important event in the world for empowering young people to be of service to their communities. How has Miss World empowered you?
Well, I would say that I have learned a lot from being at Miss World, from being a part of this experience. It has been absolutely incredible. I mean, I'm a primary school teacher in Northern Ireland, a little country girl, and now I'm standing on the Miss World stage here in front of all of you. It's absolutely crazy. But no, I think it's just, we are women from all over the globe. We are different and unique in so many ways, you know, from our background, our culture, our religion. And it has been so lovely to be able to just listen, getting that opportunity to listen to one another, share with each other our experiences, and actually learn from each other so that we can work together to achieve a much better outcome. So, yeah, I think never stop learning. That's something I have definitely learned and that has empowered me.
Oh, I think she should be a politician. That was very, very good. Okay, for Poland.
For Poland, what is the most important discovery yet to be discovered? What is the most important discovery that hasn't been discovered yet that could be discovered, that you think?
The most important discovery. I believe that this is no one, but every day we learn something new. And we all have unique experiences. And all of us can learn something about ourselves. And to be more authentic and personal, what I've discovered is that it costs us so little to enrich the life of others. And this is the cost that we can all afford. And believe me, it's worth its price. So if you would like to discover something new, just try to learn to be rich more in empathy, in compassion, in gratitude, because we can all do it. As I mentioned before, we can all be great because everyone can serve. And this discovery seems so simple, but it's actually life-weaving. Thank you.
Excellent, thank you. Final question.
Very nice, thank you. And final question, please.
Final question for Mix Mexico. What would you say to the future generations about protecting the planet?
I've always believed that child are the future of our world. Therefore, we need to really take care of them and share love. And something very important nowadays is also letting them know the importance of taking care of our planet. We take this planet for granted, but it is not. We enjoy nature. I personally love nature. And I think that what we really need to do is start from home. Everything is determined by home. Children's youth is the most determining age in someone's life. And therefore, everyone who is listening to me and all the children who surround you, we are all responsible for taking care of this planet. Thank you.
Okay, we'll be back after the break. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Now, the moment of truth has arrived. There is only one person who knows the results. Allow me to introduce to you the chairman and CEO of the Miss World organization. Please give a really big round of applause to Julia Morley.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to announce the results from the reverse order. The second runner-up is... Côte d'Ivoire. Runner-up is United States of America.
It's been a wonderful evening. We've crowned a new Miss World. Congratulations, Poland. Join us for the 71st Miss World next year. In the meantime, get on your feet.